Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about human relation school. We have already covered classical school of the thought of public administration. Now we will discuss what is human relation school. This is one of the school which evolved in response to the classical school of thought, which was mostly based on the mechanical output of the, and it was more of scientific management of the labor force. But human relation school thought was a counterpoint, and this was propagated by Herman Simon, who classified administrative behavior, the study of the bureaucracy. In order to understand the decision making, it is better to understand the structure of organization, because the structure determines behavior of the human. Human relation relating to motivation and increasing job satisfaction. The study of human relation and motivation determines the performance of the organization. Also, decision making studies emphasize cognitive abilities. It tries to enhance the cognitive abilities of the management team, which tries to increase the output of the laborers through the use of motivation, through the use of incentives and other measures. Individuals' behavior, cognitive decision making process and others develop over a longer period of times. So in this school of behavioral thought, the schools looked at human motivation and social environment in which the organization work. They studied the behavior of individual in the organization and the effect of the main contributor to the behavioral school bears, Herbert. So we will discuss what is behavior. This is the fundamental of understanding the theory. Behavior is defined as general sense, as action of people that are seen. As we can see in the figure, the behavior that can seen is really the tip of the iceberg. Below the tip is the unseen attitude of the person. So human relation school and the behavioral school of the thoughts are many things in common. So what are those things? Both focus on motivation of the people. Both emphasize clarity of communication from the management to the workers. They emphasize on the interpersonal relationship, how people relate with each other. Both look at the individual and group behavior of the organization. The main contributor of behavioral theory were first Douglas McGraw and Abraham Maslow. Douglas McGraw, he was presented the theory called theory X and theory Y. His theory X and Y are the negative and positive assumptions about the behavior. So what is theory X? Theory X is the positive behavior that every individual displays, and the theory Y is the positive assumption about human behavior, and its assumptions are just like the opposite of X. People accept responsibility because they are willing to work and agile and active. They want to achieve the goal. They can exercise control because they are responsible. They want to have control over things, and they want to be creative in their work. Can work as natural as rest or play. For people, work and rest equal. Rest all the time because they want to have some rest. So Maslow's need hierarchy. This is very important concept in the study of the behavioral school of thought. So what is this? So Abraham Maslow has defined five stages of hierarchy of the needs that every individual pursue to complete in his life. So these are five categories which we'll discuss here. First one is the physiological and social. These are social, love, esteem and self-actualization. So systems school of thought is another concept in the public administration. The main contributors of the system school of thoughts were Fairmont E. Cast and James Rosenwein. There are two basic components of any system. So what are these systems? So these systems school views organization as a unified purposeful system composed of interrelated parts. The theory proves opportunity to look at how they interact with one another. Parts of organization. An organization is composed of different parts, and it can be in the form of department, it can be in the form of different hierarchy. So any organization comprises of subsystems. So here we can see that one organization can be divided into further different subsystems, like different department, different divisions of the organization. So key concepts in system school of the thought are subsystems, the part that make the whole synergy. Whole is greater than the sum of its part. The combined effect of the system is greater than its individual parts. Subsystem boundaries separates system from external environment. They are open and closed systems.